Hello. Dunbar. And then Bombay. 106 original India Pale Ale. It's a familiar trait with Dunnabrays. They've all got a tendency to explode. Hence the towel prepared. Anyway, here we go. Light amber, maybe yellow brown. Very white head. Smelling in some straw, hay, a touch of lime. Anyway, there you go. You're getting a subtle hint of lime, a strong bitter taste. The straw is very strong on the smell and the taste. It's 7%. Let's have a look. Named after the 106th Brigade of the East India Trading Company, who later became the 2nd Battalion of Durham Light Infantry. This type of beer was drunk in India all this time. So it's a bit on it's slightly burning on the back of the palate. Very pale Maris Otter malt and traditional English Gotland hops replicate the original pale bitter. I'm getting so much bitter. Bitterness is robust but well rounded with that must be else because I'm getting like peppery burning note. And it says it's spicy peppery finish and heavily edit alcohol esters. Food match curries, other heavily flavoured foods, and also sticky chips. There's water, barley, wheat, hops, and yeast. Suitable for vegans. This is the Guile 2277. This ale is bottle conditioned in the boom. There is live cinnamon, which continues to mature and develop the flavour and character. Carbonation, sticky fingers as well. Yep, there you go. I cannot say I like this beer. Well, I'm gonna keep trying it. Heavy on the straw. The tropical fruits are slightly coming out now. It does smell like a farmhouse cheese, which I have had. As it gets more room temperature and all that, more flavors pop out. But And yeah, I mean, Animus is a 7% beer, but it's okay. But what about again? The thing about dumb beers is that they're like a treat to yourself. Like a special thing because they're so expensive to buy per bottle. But that royalty, is it really worth it when there's so many better beers out there? Anyway, you take care. Goodbye.